So you clicked on this video, and therefore I have a feeling that you enjoy ancient history and you want to know more about ancient structures and how people lived in the ancient world, human evolution, new archaeological discoveries. And maybe, since you clicked on this particular one, maybe you want to know more about diseases and how they came to life, or how old they are, or where they came from, as far as we can find out. If that's the case, then I highly suggest you subscribe to the channel. Click on that bell icon to be notified whenever I upload, and if you enjoy my work, you can always consider becoming a patron or a channel member. So in this day and age, in 2022, I honestly, unfortunately, feel like it's safe to say that everyone has encountered the disease of cancer in one way or another. Either you've dealt with it yourself, like you fought the disease yourself, or you know someone who has fought against it. Maybe you're like me and you've lost a loved one to it. Unfortunately, many people have to live with this particular loss. This disease destroys a lot. It seems like a lot of people think that cancer is quite a new disease, that it has only been here on the planet for maybe a few thousand years. But what if I told you that that's not really the case? Actually, it's not the case at all. What if cancer is so old that it evolved alongside the ancient human species and their mutations, and it seems to have plagued us, the human species, for nearly 2 million years. So my name is Kaylee, and in this video, I'm going to take a look into the oldest discovered piece of cancer on an ancient human, and into the oldest discovered malignant tumor on a turtle bone that shows that cancer has actually been plaguing the planet and its inhabitants for approximately 240 million years, at the very least, since the dawn of the dinosaurs. So when I was young, I didn't hear much about the disease, cancer. I knew maybe two people that were affected by it in some way, shape, or form during my childhood in the 90s. And in the early 2000s, I started to hear more about the disease and people affected by it. And nowadays, in 2022, there's no one that I know at this point in my life that hasn't been affected by cancer in one way or another. Dealt with it themselves, or lost a loved one. So was this my personal perception? Was it less prevalent in the 90s compared to now? Or was I simply a child that had her focus on different aspects in life instead of diseases that plagued humankind? These are a few questions to which I will probably never really know the answer, but thankfully, there is a lot I am able to answer when it comes to the disease known as cancer. And it's not fun, but it is something that we have to talk about. So first, let's try and uncover where the idea of cancer being a relative new disease comes from. Of course, we all think that microwaves give us cancer. Yeah, no, not really. Or maybe, I don't know. I'm not really that type of scientist. But up until approximately 2016, the belief was that cancer was a few thousand years old, with the oldest cancerous growth having been found on Egyptian and Peruvian mummies dating back to approximately 1500 BCE. There is, of course, a reason why it seemed that cancer was a young disease when looking at the historical records. And this has to do with the fact that cancer mostly afflicts people in the age group of 65 and older. And when looking at the lifespan of ancient humans, not many would be able to even reach such an old age. Yes, sorry, in ancient times, it was considered an old age, while in modern times, the age of 65 is considered to still be quite young. And because we have extended the human lifespan, we have unveiled the cancerous spread in our society, and therefore it has become more prevalent. And that, as you can imagine, can make it look like cancer was quite the new or young disease, only a few thousand years old. I mean, that up until then was sort of the oldest proof of it. Although I find this idea a bit strange, looking at 2016, because it was in 2001 that a brow bone of a Neanderthal was discovered in the North Sea, where Doggerland used to be. Covered Doggerland in a video, thumbnail right here. Highly recommend. And I covered the brow bone and the Neanderthal actually in that video. But this brow bone showed a cavity of 8 by 5 millimeters, and this indicates that Krein, the Neanderthal, which is the name given to the individual, he had a slow growing tumor that probably made him suffer, most likely, but it probably didn't kill him. In 2009, the brow bone was published and presented as the first Neanderthal in the Netherlands, and the fossil has been dated to come from 50,000 to 70,000 years ago. The Krein, the Neanderthal, lived between 50,000 and 70,000 years ago, and he had a tumor. That's cancer. So this in itself already showed that the disease of cancer was around at least 50,000 to 70,000 years. And therefore, the idea that it was only a few thousand years old is already silly, in my personal opinion. So what we do know is that the very first description of cancer in written text dates back to approximately 3000 BCE, which was discovered in Egypt. As you all know, writing isn't older than approximately 5 or 6 thousand years in total. So of course, the fact that in the historical texts we can't find any evidence of it further back is because there's no written record further back. So even though the word cancer wasn't used, it described numerous cancerous growths like tumors and ulcers of the breast, which were removed by cauterization with specific tools known as the fire drill. Although the writings about this disease, most likely written by Imhotep, the architect of the Djoser pyramid, the writing about the disease actually speaks that there's no treatment being available for it. So now that we know that, we can look at the origins of the word cancer. Where does the word cancer actually originate from? This is a question that I've heard people ask more than once in my life. So I think it's good to take a very quick look at it. The origin of the word cancer seems to come from the hands, or better yet, the mouth, of the Greek physician Hippocrates, who lived between 460 and 370 BCE. He got old. Wow. Hippocrates is often considered to be the father of medicine, and he used two terms to describe cancer. Carcinos as a non-ulcer-forming tumor, and carcinoma to describe ulcer-forming tumors. A fun thing to note is that carcinos and carcinoma are Greek words for crabs. Hippocrates most likely gave these names to the tumors because of the similarities of the way the finger-like spreading projections from the cancer that sort of look like the legs and therefore the shape of a crab. Later on, the Roman physician Celsus, who lived between 25 BCE and 50 AD, translated the terms carcinos and carcinoma to the Latin word for crab, which is the word cancer. And later on, again, another Greek physician, Galen, who lived from approximately 130 AD until 200 AD, used the word onkos to describe the tumors, which is the Greek word for swelling. This is actually where the name for the cancer specialists is derived from, oncologists. So now that I've quickly covered the sort of origins of the misconception that cancer is a relative new disease, and now that I've covered the origins of the name of the disease, I think it's time to take a look into the oldest ever discovered tumor on a human species that dates back to 1.7 million years ago. That's a long time ago. Yes. You heard that right from my mouth. The oldest ever discovered tumor on a species of human dates back to 1.7 million years ago. And I personally, but this is not factual, I personally feel that the species was a Homo erectus, because that was sort of like the human species that lived at the time. And if you've ever watched a few of my videos on human evolution and species of humans that have lived in the past, you more than likely have heard me talk about the cradle of humankind in South Africa. This is a region in Africa that's incredibly rich in fossils from different species of humans and australopithecines spanning over a few million years. So it's not really that peculiar that it was in this particular region, once again, that there are actually a lot of discoveries made here. So there's the Swartkrans Cave, and archaeologists have found a toe bone in that cave, in which they have discovered a quite aggressive type of cancer known as osteosarcoma. This unknown human relative, or individual of an ancient human species, died inside the Swartkrans Cave between 1.6 and 1.8 million years ago. Therefore, we conclude that the estimation of this tumor dates back to 1.7 million years ago. It's safe to grab the middle. So back in 2016, this discovery was actually published in the South African Journal of Science. And this paper suggests that even though our modern way of life has increased the spread of cancer in our human population, especially in industrialized countries, this find actually shows that cancer has been with us, plaguing us, since the very dawn of humanity. No matter what diet you have, how clean you live, your environment, or anything else that you can control, it is no use when it comes to the possibility of one day having to cope with the disease known as cancer, as it's been with us our entire evolutionary past. It has evolved alongside us. Cancer has been there since the very first species in the Homo genus, and it seems like there is no escaping this disease unless we are able to keep finding new technologies and medications that could help fight against this wrecking disease. Like, it destroys everything. So the problem that we as a society have with a disease like cancer is the fact that we as a species evolve. And unfortunately, the cancer evolves alongside us. And as our technologies and medication improve, the cancer will find new ways to evolve so that it won't be affected by these technologies and medications. That's what evolution does. Fighting a disease like cancer is like, to give a metaphor, it's like mopping the floors with the faucets open. It's sort of a never-ending battle, but we can't let ourselves get discouraged because we can prevail. I look at it like sort of like this. The Dutch people and our never-ending battle with the water surrounding us. We've had floods that tore the country apart, ripped thousands of people away from us in one night, like it did in 1953 with the Great Flood. But we created the Delta Works, and we are currently mastering this fight for as long as we can. I'm not saying that in the end we will win, but we will continue to fight for as long as we can. And that's actually what we're doing with cancer as well, and the way that we combat this terrible disease. So cancer has actually been here for a lot longer in other species that have roamed the planet before us, long before the humans and their ancestors even roamed the Earth. In fact, cancer has been here since the dawn of the dinosaurs for at least 240 million years. Since the Triassic period, cancer has been plaguing living creatures on this planet. And we know this for a fact because paleontologists have actually discovered a malignant tumor on a 240 million year old turtle bone. That's insanity. This actually might be the earliest evidence of cancer ever found. The discovery was made by a group of scientists in Germany. So they discovered a highly malignant tumor in the fossilized leg bone of a stem turtle, which is a species of turtle that lived during the Triassic period, around the dawn of the dinosaurs, as the Triassic period saw many new species emerge. The stem turtle was of the Papocheles rocinae species, which is a shell-less, now extinct ancestor of the modern turtles. This fossil was presented to the world in 2015. And around this time, one of the discoverers noticed an uneven growth running along one of the thigh bones. So a team of paleontologists and physicians in Germany went to analyze the fossil with a micro CT scan, and they came to the conclusion that it was a highly malignant bone tumor known as periosteal osteosarcoma. There we go again. Osteosarcoma. So the strangest thing about this entire discovery is that the tumor of approximately 240 million years ago looks nearly identical to osteosarcoma in modern humans. That's crazy. Osteosarcoma, again, was also the oldest known type of cancer found in an early human ancestor, like I mentioned just a few minutes ago. So there's actually quite a good reason why we mostly have found osteosarcoma in these millions of year old fossils. What is that reason, you may ask? I'll answer that to you. Most cancers actually grow in the soft tissues of a living being, and therefore it degrades over time, leaving usually no trace at all. But osteosarcoma is a bone cancer, so when the bone gets fossilized, we can discover it later on. So knowing that cancer has been plaguing the living creatures on this planet since as early as the Triassic period, the dawn of the dinosaurs, it seems that this is a disease that is vulnerable to mutation and that it's rooted deep within our own DNA. So we can only hope that science one day gets to the point of being able to fight against all types of cancer and that it will no longer be a death sentence. It would be wonderful if that would be the case one day. And until then, the fight continues. And I commend everyone who's fighting their battle and everyone supporting their loved ones in their fight. It's the least we can do. Support the people who are fighting against this terrible disease. And for those who've seen my Instagram post or seen it on Twitter or on my Facebook or in my community tab here on YouTube, I postponed my Malta trip due to the fact that I got really homesick at the end in Egypt and I feel like I'm starting to like burn out a little bit, and I feel like having that extra travel plan for 10 days away, it's a bit too much for me next month. Especially when from September 15th until October 16th, I'll be in Egypt doing two tours back to back. And I said due to mental health reasons, and I'm not lying about that. But besides that, I'm doing fine. Don't worry about me. I'll be good. I saw this early on, so I've made the decision to change plans and make sure that I'll be okay. And take good care of myself. I take this very seriously, but yeah, it's not smart for me to travel more than I've been doing already. And I've been traveling a lot, and it's already changing my life since I used to never travel at all. So don't worry about me, I'll be fine. But yeah, I'm not going to Malta next month. I'll be going to Malta in the springtime. Still going back to Malta because holy hell, I really love Malta. And Laura from Megalith Hunter. You should subscribe to her actually. If you want to join me on the tour in Egypt, go to adeptexpeditions.com and book your spot. I'm probably only going to do this once in my life. One tour and I'll be done because it's a lot of stress and it's a lot to cope with. And I'm an ambivert, which means that I'm an extroverted introvert. But I really need to recharge and be alone a lot. So once and probably never again. But with that said, if you enjoyed watching this video, then don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you'd like to see more of these kind of videos, and click that bell icon to be notified whenever I upload. If you haven't seen my previous videos yet, then click the card in the upper right corner, or click one of the links in the description down below, or click a video in the end card. Whatever floats your boat. I want to thank all my patrons and my channel members. Thank you so much for your support of me and the channel. I'll be making regular videos, like I won't disappear. Don't worry. I'm not gonna leave y'all, okay? But yeah, thank you for watching, and share this video with people because apparently not many people knew this kind of information and I think it's important to share it. So yeah, have a great day or evening or night, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!